Only 4,585 pounds. This is a little Gray Wolf couples camper here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan that just came in on trade. And dang, is this thing clean? It is one owner, as I mentioned. We originally sold it to the original owner, and they were so happy with it, they're actually staying within the Gray Wolf family and just sizing up a little bit. This is basically the exact same layout as a 2106 FBS Winnebago Micro Mini. But this is built with conventional construction methods, and it's a full 8 foot wide. Yet it's really not that much heavier than one of those little Winnebago Micro Minis, so you're just going to get more space here, and you are not, as far as I can see, with a pretty well-educated eye on these things, you are not inheriting someone else's problems. Everything appears to still like be whatever was in this from the factory, still here, still in good shape. Because the slide, the sofa slide, is above the wheel wells, that means the whole slide had to be above the floor, which means the entire main deck can be carpetless. But because there's no, like, carpeting to go within a slide, this is a completely carpetless, easy-cleaning, pet-friendly camper. Very sharp-type stuff here. Now, being a full 8 foot wide versus the more common, modern instances of this layout, does give you more room to walk around the bed. You get a normal queen-width bed. You can obviously easily upgrade from the camp queen that's here to a true queen and not interfere with the slide, so that's no big deal. And you get bigger side stands with larger overhead storage. The side stands have household outlets on both sides, and you'll notice how there's household outlets right next to the slide also. So if you want to sit there with a phone charger or something plugged in, you can. You see that bundle of wires up there on the mattress? That is the controller for the mattress heating elements. So, you might just want to throw like a foam topper on top of that and enjoy the mattress heaters, or obviously you could just upgrade to a different bed, heated or not, totally up to you. The cabinetry here, simple but effective. Not fancy pants, raised panel, hardwood doors or nothing like that. Simple flat panel cabinetry, but it's effective. And that's exactly what this camper is. It is simple, clean, effective camping. It's not fireplaces and ceiling fans, although those things are nice. I'm not casting judgment. I'm not throwing shade. I'm just simply saying that this is for folks who just want to go out and camp a little. You know, you don't want to necessarily glamp a little. No oven, which I think is actually a good decision in a small camper like this because it gives you another very large storage drawer right there. The entertainment system on this is pretty basic, but again, pretty effective. This was built right on the cusp of when manufacturers were first starting to adjust to flat screen TVs in the main camper market. But that's a good thing, because that means that those are extra deep storage cabinets up there. Now, the sofa can jackknife down pretty flat into a sleeper, but that's a three adult sized seating sofa. So, I don't know, realistically, an adult could probably sleep on that, although I would only limit that to one. Now, classic Forest River thing right here, you see that shelf kind of behind the sofa? There's an outside storage compartment behind that mounted on the slide face, which is pretty darn nice. Inside, look at this. This is, they left everything in such factory shape, the original, like, propaganda tags from the manufacturer. Some of those are still in here. Holy crap, dude. But, I mean, you can see it. The floor, the sinks, everything is clean. And I know they used it. These folks camped a lot, you know. The bathroom back here has some tremendous storage. So, first of all, you saw that big sink we just went past, but you see that oversized medicine cabinet. Now, back here, we also get this huge closet with some extra sort of pocket space. Now, before you have a heart attack and you're going, oh my God, what's wrong with this broken panel? It's not broken. This is the water heater access because this camper is currently winterized, and you can see how the little screws are still present and accounted for in there. Right across from it, we've got ourselves our simple little tub shower combo. You might notice there's no shower surround paneling on here. Don't have a heart attack. All you have to do, and this is how RVs existed for 40 plus years, guys, so there's nothing wrong with this. It works just fine. When you're done taking a shower, you take your towel, you go like that, and you're done. That's all there is to it. And overall, the exterior's held up pretty well. I don't see anything that... I think it looks better than average for its age. I'll just fire it off that way. Now, This was one of the first years where the Cherokee family began to offer what's called the limited package. And it included a whole bunch of gizmos and whiz-bangs. Like you can see these little leveling indicators. There's one over there, one over there. I've heard mixed reviews on those things. This one looks like maybe the polar vortex cold crack got a hold of it a little bit. They're battery powered. Some folks really liked them. Some folks said they didn't work very well. I don't know. I just always use the level app on my phone to do camper leveling and it works just fine. So, you know, understand that may or may not be a good working thing. It's definitely not worth the price of trying to find and replace one of those, I can tell you that. Little toy lock system down here so that if you do, you know, bring a couple bicycles or whatever, really, you can make sure that your stuff stays on your campsite because it's got a aircraft grade cable hooking it up to the trailer. Power tongue jack, power awning, painted aluminum front nose sweep with an extra thick skin. Basically means the whole front of this is effectively like diamond plate. It just doesn't look brutal, you know, metal. This does not have any sort of special underbelly, heating, cooling, insulation package, none of that. I didn't look at the tires. Sometimes I remember, sometimes I don't. They look good to me. I don't see any sort of weather checking. I don't see wacky wear patterns, so the camper was not overloaded or anything like that. Everything looks good. Let's get on the back here. You see that folding cargo travel rack on the back right there? So when I mentioned the bicycles, you've got the perfect little place to transport them. Doesn't have a ladder on the back, but it does have a fully walkable roof. So, you know, when you need to do your seasonal maintenance and upkeep, no biggie deal there. Spare tires never touch the ground that I can see. The spare tire cover is weathered a little bit, but that's kind of its job. The cover is intended to be somewhat of a throwaway item so that, you know, the tire itself doesn't become a throwaway item. You want to know a quick little camping hack, guys? Like, I like the fact that the wolf's face and the word gray wolf is facing right side up, but the top of this experiences the worst of sun, wind, rain, weather exposure. Well, if you take that slip cover off, you rotate it 90 degrees, put it back on. Well, look at this. Now we've got a whole new surface that can absorb all this weather instead of the top of it continuing to deteriorate. Now, the word gray wolf might appear on a 90 degree angle, but do you really care how the spare tire cover looks? Or do you care if the spare tire itself works? Because I know that I really want that spare tire to work in the event of a oh my god emergency kind of situation. So I mentioned the power awning, mentioned the tires look good. You do have outside TV hookups with a quick release bracket that would marry up with the bracket inside should you choose to add a flat screen to the camper. This is intended to be a control panel to operate your stereo system from the outside of the RV. Kind of like a couple other the little gadgets and gizmos that are put on this camper. Mixed reviews on that, which is one of the reasons they don't really do it anymore. Now, I'm going to say the exact same thing about this. This is a one of the dollar cheapest South Co. keyless entry door pads I've ever seen. Frankly, most of them didn't really work well when the camper is brand new. I would assume, especially this component, does not work. Now, that's two or three different little gadget things on this camper that I've kind of advised I would expect not to work. But I've also spoken very highly of this camper. So, like, what's going on? Well, see, the thing is, when they first came up with this limited package, the supplier of all these little whiz-bangs and gizmos, they basically told Cherokee, tell you what, we are going to effectively nearly give these to you all but free of charge. And you can make your camper look like it's really neat and fancy and has all these high-class, cool, fun features. Well, what they didn't say is we're also going to give you the cheapest components we possibly can to put on your camper. So those things had nothing to do with Cherokee. They had 100% of things to do with the supplier, and those widgets weren't used the next year. So Cherokee obviously recognized where they were good, where they weren't, and made adjustments accordingly. But the fact of the matter is, if you ignore a couple gizmos that if they weren't there, you wouldn't care, this is a really nice camper. If you are looking, if you have a small vehicle, if you're looking to get started with couples camping, or if you want to upgrade to a slide out or get rid of a hybrid or pop-up, a situation like that, this is an excellent starter camper, and frankly, it would just be a good, you know, more budget-friendly used couples camper at that. I don't think you even have to be an entry-level customer. It's just a good floor plan. So, give us a call, 800-256-5196. We are Haylett RV. We're the largest independent RV dealer in the state of Michigan. We do hitching, pieces, parts, trades, financing, truck and trailer package deals, RV delivery, and everything between. So take care, stay safe, have fun. Whew, happy camping, everyone.